Aloha, big wave trading family. Before we get started with the new long positions, I want to just make a couple of housekeeping notes to let everyone realize that what's happening right now is not normal. It's very unusual and it's weird. Normally, when the markets are hitting all-time highs across every index and every market, minus the Dow Jones Industrial Average, which is kind of lagging right here, but still just recently hit new highs the previous week. You normally have stocks blasting off immediate follow through and producing some pretty solid gains right away. But because the VIX is at an all-time low, I mean, think about that, all-time low. We are simply not getting the massive moves in short periods of times that I love to see that come following major market corrections. Now, when the markets stage massive corrections, like you can see here in 2015, look at what the VIX does. Now, after the VIX moves like this and the market has a correction like this, you eventually get a follow-through day and you get buyable long patterns. Those stocks normally, as long as the market is trading in a pretty, I guess you could say, calm fashion, are going to produce the huge, huge, huge gains. But markets that are at all-time highs with the VIX at all-time lows, you're not going to get huge gains. And another problem that we continue to see is I'm just receiving a massive amount of long signals. Now, I want to show you how the Russell 2000 at the end of 2015 to right around the 2016 lows managed to lose right around 20%. Now, when all the indexes lose 20%, that's a real reset I can work with to make some big, big, massive gains. Now, you'll notice here since that reset, there hasn't been a whole lot of stocks that have produced longer term winning gains. I'm long AERI from some point back here. That's almost a 1 year hold, but that is it. And that's very rare before 2008, very normal post 2008. So as long as we get a market that just refuses to correct 20% market wide. So like look at the Nasdaq here. It only corrected 17% whenever the S&P or whenever the Russell 2000 corrected 20%. Look at the S&P 500 to right around these lows, it only corrected 13%. I need a market wide flush of 20% or more. That will call all of my laggards, keep only the leaders in my current portfolio, and will then set up patterns that give me long signals that I can push 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10% of my capital per position into capital into each position. But as long as we do this grind where the market refuses to sell off in any meaningful way and then continues to do this V-shaped move to new highs. Now, mind you, look at the Nasdaq before Friday session. Look at that, up 10 days in a row, V-shaped manner into new highs on below average volume, on volume lower than the sell-off from the high in June, July. This is the new norm. This pattern here has shown up every time the Nasdaq has gone to hit new highs since 2008. Folks, this is not healthy. Hopefully, this quantitative easing market gives way to an earnings-led bull run here, and we get our final blow-off as this extremely long 8-year bull market's getting ridiculous. But I'm just going to play it day by day, which brings me to the point of the new long positions. I hate this. I do not want to be giving everyone 5 new long signals, 7 new long signals, 3 new long signals, 4 new long signals. I would love to get 10 long signals that give me clear 10% entry signals to where I know that my risk to reward ratio is I'm only risking about 1% for every 10% possible reward in the stock. And I'm not going to get that until the market corrects. There's real fear in the market. And as long as we do this weird V-shape, low volume move to new highs, we are susceptible to this continued thing where we grind higher and then have a sell-off, grind higher, sell-off, grind higher, sell-off, grind higher, sell-off. And we're just going to continue to do this pattern, which is just going to make end-of-day gains very hard. So I want to make this very clear. I'm tracking or long and or long the second most amount of stocks I've ever been in my entire investing career. The last time this happened was 2007 before the 2008 market crash. What's funny is that back then, My gains were almost twice as much as they are now. I'm only up right around 25% on the year aggregate in all of my portfolios, and it's due to the way this market is uptrending and because I'm long so many stocks that it's really hurting the performance. But once again, I'm not getting any clear long signals. I don't know how to differentiate right now the stocks that are moving 25% in 3 days from the stocks that fail 5% in 5 days. There's just no rhyme or reason to what pattern works. I track oversold swing trades, continuation breakout patterns. They're all right around 60%. There's none that's 70-30. There's none that's 40-60. There's none that's 50-50. They're all 60-40. And the winners to losers are only about 2 to 3 to 1. Back in before 2008, they were consistently 3 to 4 to 5 to 1 every single time. And the win-loss ratio was 65 to 35. And in uptrend, 70 to 30, we've had past subscribers track and follow it. Those subscribers no longer do it, and or those subscribers are no longer with us because this is a tricky market. Now, just to give you an example about the 200 stocks that I'm tracking or long, just to give you a difference about how different my end of day methodology is to whenever I'm day trading, I only day trade when I have 50% or more capital and or have a manageable amount of positions. So if I was long 90% of my capital in 9 stocks, with that rest of that 10% capital, I can day trade. I have no issues. I'm not cross-referencing charts and timeframes. But whenever I have this many long stocks and I'm so fully invested, there I just cannot keep my mind separate, because with my brokerages open, I'm going to be seeing my stop orders hit, which is always going to cause me to go look at them and distract me from what's happening. So day trading wise, how many stocks can I handle personally intraday? What's the most stocks I've ever been long at one moment intraday on a day trade? 2. What's the most stocks I can handle following intraday? 4. So think about that. 2 stocks I can be have actual live trades on. 3 stocks most. 4 stocks is the most I can track. 3 is what I'm normally tracking at the start of the day. And then later on, we'll see which ones are holding near the high of the day for the end of the day. But right now with all these long positions, I can't do it. It's impossible. Plus, I'm fully invested. So tonight's long signals, first off, PETS is a 3% long signal. AMED's a 3% long signal. DNKN's a 2% long signal. CAI's a 1% long signal. BJRI's a 1% long signal. I don't even have that much capital that I can put. So I can't put 12,000 into PETS. I can't put 4,000 into CAI. I have to pare it back. That's how fully long I am. But going over the long positions really quick, because once again, are these great signals? No. Do they have the proper reward ratios? Yes, so I'm taking them, but maybe you shouldn't. It's summertime, seasonally terrible. We're about to enter the worst seasonal period for stocks, August, September through October. And the market's uptrend is weird, low VIX environment, so maybe you shouldn't take any of these. But if you do, obey what I'm doing. So let's go. PETS. Limit order, 40.55, first cut loss, 38.77 for me, and then I'll have a wide one at 36.10. This low gets taken out on heavier volume or it loses green bop. Hopefully, this level never comes into play. I'll be raising my stops immediately. So 40.55 PETS, 38.77, 36.10. AMED, this is probably the highest quality long position with the best reward risk ratio. So if there's any trade you should take, this is the one it should be. AMED, getting long, 59.44. First cut loss, 57.88. Me, my only cut loss, 57.52. Clear, cut. Basing, expect it to curl, turn higher. Curling, turning higher, expect it to do every single time it moves off its lows, just like DNKN. DNKN has earnings next week, but I don't care. This stock has a history, as you can see, whenever it's rounding and trying to build a low, which I don't have in here, my RSI and MACD indicators, this stock curls higher. How much it decides to curl higher, I don't know, but hopefully earnings catalyst is there. But DNKN, getting long, 53.69. 52.97, my first cut loss. 51.93, my final cut loss. Then BJRI, clear, crystal clear, oversold swing trade RSI play. Getting long, 35. Final cut loss and only cut loss, 33.95. And then CAI, getting long at 25.10. The pivot point area, not the close, not the high of the day. 1 cent above the breakout level of 25.13, because I wanted to get long this damn stock back here, but BOP fell. BOP fell, so I didn't buy it. Now I want in, now that I'm missing out. So getting long, 25.14 hopefully. First cut loss, 23.51. Final cut loss, 22.60. And then the two swing trades, DFFN getting long at 220. First cut loss 210. Emergency cut loss if it fills the gap 197. And then EARS, I'm going to give it a shot here. First going long at 88 with that first tight stop at 84. And then I'm willing to give it back to 76. But like I said, if it fails this level, I'll be getting out of ears partially anyway. I just like the way that it's coiling here with the max green bop appears ready to go, just like DFFN. Just love that volume surge and the bop surge. So it all looks good. But right now, probably cash is king if you're not already long with us into new highs, because the V-shaped grinding always have nasty one-day pullbacks. We'll see if that happens on Monday.